नमस्कार, वेलकम टू डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जर्नलिज्म एंड मास कम्युनिकेशन। आई एम अलेख सच्चिदानंद, विद मी आवर स्टूडेंट।
माय नेम इज अगस्त मुनि मिश्रा एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट ऑडियो एंड वीडियो प्रोडक्शन।
माय नेम इज एकता योगी, आई एम एन एजर्स।
ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डिस्कस व्हाट काइंड ऑफ कैमरा वी कुड हैव। कैमरा वी कुड से इट्स ए इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइस। प्रीवियसली देयर आर camera which physically we have to do everything, but today we have a computing system inside the camera so that it could record light, intensity of light. The basic fundamental practice or work of a camera is to capture the light, intensity of light. Previously you have a reel which is coated with some chemicals, but now you have sensor inside the camera and which could able to capture the intensity of light. So when we look after any scenario, any shot or scene, we could find different kind of colors are there. So it means it represent different forms of light, light in different wavelength, and that we need to capture with help of our camera. So before discussing in detail these specification and practice how camera work, let's talk about what kind of camera we could have. So every camera have the same mechanism that they have to capture the light. They have to capture the visuals. Okay, so in our studio we have a different kind of equipment. Here you could say it's a mirrorless camera, and this is DSLR. Okay, so this is the DSLR. Mostly we are using this camera for photography. Nowadays, this camera is capable enough to record video also. But main purpose of this camera is to capture photographs. Okay, so there, this camera has a specific features that with help of this viewfinder, you could see exactly what we are going to capture. So this is the beauty of this camera. Okay, so before taking any pictures, you could preview with help of viewfinder, and also there is a monitor, digital monitor. This also give you the complete feedback, complete feed of your scene or what you want to capture. So there is a prism which could able to help you to see what you want to you are going to capture. And this is the DSLR camera, and this one is a mirrorless camera. And only difference is there is a prism inside this DSLR camera to practically or physically watch what you are going to capture. But this viewfinder have a digital display, and that display you are going to see in this mirrorless camera. So difference is only one mechanism, one feature gets reduced, but you could do everything with help of this mirrorless camera, and it's more portable comparison to this DSLR use camera. Okay, and another feature of this DSLR or mirrorless camera, we could change its lens as per our need. We could replace its lens. Let me see. Okay, one thing you have to keep in mind when you deal with this kind of camera, try to put it in your neck so that it will not going to accidentally it could fall, some damage could happen. So try to put it like this, or you have hold here and you could press. Let me show you closely. So you could press here and turn it clockwise. No, it's anti-clockwise, and could open. So remember that you have to turn off your camera, okay, while you open this lens. Okay, and then you could replace another lens as per your need. In the next session, we'll discuss what the role of this lens and how, in what situation you have to use what kind of lens. Okay, so this is another. This is zoom lens. This is 70 to 300. We could change its focal length, and just try to see. You could see here one red sign is there. Okay, and in some lens there will be white mark will be there. And just match this with the red match. Okay, just you could take the camera close to. Okay, so you have to match this two, and you have to place like this, and just rotate it clockwise. And this camera is now ready. So we are talking about the DSLR camera. Okay, So in every camera you could see there is an opening where light enter inside the camera, and that light get captured with help of one sensor will be there, and you could see the sensor. If we open this camera, let me take out this lens. Okay, again you have to press here like this, then rotate it in anti-clockwise. You could keep it here, and here you could see, okay, there is a mirror. Okay, there is a mirror which reflect the light to your viewfinder with help of a prism. There you could see there is a prism, and this is the specification, therefore we called it DSLR. Mm-hmm. Only for this mechanism, this mirror going to capture the visuals, and in the viewfinder you could see. Now you could not see anything because we don't have lens. The main purpose of lens is to take the light and focus in on the sensor or in your mirror, and therefore this is the basic fundamental mechanism of any DSLR camera. And same mechanism is there in the mirrorless camera, but there is no mirror, so therefore we call it mirror camera, and this is mirrorless camera. If we click here, its mirror will be turned off, and your camera sensor will be exposed to light, and it will going to capture the picture. Okay, so ye basic yahi hai. Clear, mere kaam se any doubt? Okay, this is, let's isko laga dete hain. First of all, you have to match this to red button. You could see here red dot in the camera, you could find, and in the here also you could find. Just match it and rotate it. Okay, take this camera and take this carefully. Chalo, ab baat karte hain ek mirrorless camera. So this is same, the mechanism is same. Hum isme we could change its lens. Isme hum dekh sakte hain. Ha, ek cheez aap yaad rakho, you have to switch it off, then you have to change the lens. Anything, if you want to take out any memory card or any battery, so during that time you have to switch it off. Okay, so there will be no disturbance. Okay, इसमें भी हम क्या कर सकते हैं, could change its lens. And here also you could, there is no mirror. This is the only difference. Okay, in that camera we have a mirror, but here is nothing. Sensor is directly exposed to the light. This is the sensor, you could see it. Okay, so it is light sensitive. If we switch it on, it become more sensitive. Okay, you should not do that. ओके, कभी भी अगर आप लेंस खोले हो तो स्विच ऑफ कर लेना चाहिए, क्योंकि इसमें भी देयर विल बी इलेक्ट्रिक सिग्नल विल बी देयर एंड इट विल गेट डिस्टर्ब. ओके, सो एंड यू कुड फाइंड सम पॉइंट्स आर देयर, एंड दिस पॉइंट कनेक्टेड विद द कैमरा विद हेल्प ऑफ दिस पॉइंट्स, सो दे कुड कम्युनिकेट, दिस लेंस कुड कम्युनिकेट विद दिस कैमरा. सो हियर ऑल्सो यू कुड फाइंड ए व्हाट मार्क, व्हाइट मार्क, एंड यू हैव टू मैच द व्हाइट मार्क, and you have to place it like this. So clear, what is the difference between DSLR and mirrorless camera? Okay, let's talk about some other camera. We have action camera. Okay, so this is one of the another peculiar camera. Okay, so it is tiny in nature, and you could place it at any place, any location. We call it action camera because it could capture the action of our movement. Okay, so this is small camera. This is waterproof. पानी के अंदर भी इसको ले सकते हैं. Okay, कहीं भी छत में लगा सकते हैं, बाइक में लगा सकते हैं, स्पोर्ट्स पर्सन उसको लगा के अपने कर्तव्य दिखा सकते हैं. So here also there is nothing to do. Limited control we have while we are using this camera. But it has its own advantages and limitations. In DSLR camera, we have the all control. Manually could change its sensor, change its lens, but it's fixed. Everything is fixed. But digitally also, you could manipulate this camera. So, for example, we could increase its shutter speed. We could increase its frame rate. Okay, and ISO. or you could this camera could capture 4K. We'll discuss later what is 4K and what is full HD. Basically in the industry where we all are using full HD, but now the day it's preferable if you capture any visual in 4K. If you want to see in a 4K monitors or high resolution display, so better naturally you need to capture in 1920x1080. So I want to show you another camera. This is professional camcorder. Here you could see it's a full HD 1920x1080. This is Sony camera and it's dedicated for videography. Okay. No doubt we could some camera video camera can capture the photographs also, but practically it's used only to capture the videos. So why we could have a questions that why we need to have a such a huge camera instead of even our DSLR could capture better visuals. And one thing, the sensor size of DSLR and this camcorder may be differ. DSLR camera could have higher sensor, but it has its own advantages. This can put out or you could start recording. Okay, no need to do manually everything, but still video camera have the capability to control its sensitivity, its lens, and this lens is fixed lens. Okay, you could zoom in and zoom out as per your need, but you can't change the lens, and microphone is also fixed here and everything get fixed, so it's easy to take visuals, easy to take video, do videography, easy to handle, easy to mount over a tripod. And another thing I want to discuss here, why we need a tripod? Because it has three legs, we call it tripod. So photography, videography ke liye ek mahatvapurna cheez hai ki hame stability ki chahiye. So we need this kind of tripod so that our visual will be stable visual. Main objective is that. And we try to increase stability. We have to connect physically with the wall or surface so that you could maintain stability. Or ek cheez main kehna chahunga, agar photography kar rahe ho, try to use both hands and you could take physical support, like you could take help of this wall to take in visuals and photographs. Or kabhi kabhi hum niche baith ke visuals lete hain ya photographs photo click karte hain only to increase the stability. So better you should have a tripod. So I think you have a basic understanding. Huh, another camera we have, there is a here. This is point shoot camera. Basically we use this for family purpose or for personal use, not for professional. This camera here in this camera. Okay. So we can't remove its lens. Okay. Sensor size is low, but for personal use, it's option enough to capture any moment. But we have another options today, that is our phone camera. Could you show your phone camera and tell me what kya kya isme karte hain? Ye bhi ek option hai. हाँ, तो इस कैमरा में आप देख सकते हो, इसमें भी हम बहुत सारे कुछ कर सकते हैं. इसमें हम फोटो ले सकते हैं, वीडियो ले सकते हैं, एंड ऑल्सो वी हैव सो मेनी मोड्स आर देयर. Pro modes, the panoramic mode, we could do all these things with help of our DSLR camera, and also this camera is able to capture and do all these things. Photo le sakte hain, video le sakte hain, or this different mode hum isko choose kar sakte hain. And you could ask another question to me, that why if we could do everything with help of our mobile phone, then why you need a DSLR camera? Definitely, here you could say the size of lens, size of sensor is so small in comparison to DSLR camera. Another thing, your mobile have how many megapixel?
64.
Okay, so the amount, number of megapixel is more than in comparison to your DSLR camera. Though DSLR camera have low megapixel, but it could capture more interesting or more precise and clear pictures because its sensor size is larger in comparison to this mobile camera. So I think you have a basic understanding about different kind of camera. So let's see how we could use our DSLR camera. So let's move to outside and let's discuss a little more about how. So let's move to outside. First of all, you have to observe the lighting scenario, whether it is a similar lighting. In the morning and evening, you could find same kind of light. There would not be any harsh and difficult lighting. This condition is difficult. So to capture in this scenario, try to take one kind of lighting situation. It should not, in your frame, there should not be shadow and light both. Either we take the shadow portions or take the light. And it's better to come under the shadow like this, under the building. Inside the shadow, you have to paint everything inside the shadow. So you'll get even similar kind of background. Otherwise, camera will get confused whether you want to capture the brightest portions or darker portion. So either we take darker part or. So let's start. So in the camera, we have already discussed. It has a body which have a sensor and which is sensitive toward light. Okay, so if you want to capture any bright light, we have to decrease its sensitivity. Okay, if the condition is dark one, we have to increase its sensitivity. And physically, digitally, we could call it ISO. It's the international standard to calculate or notify the sensitivity of a sensor. And switch on your camera and put it in your neck. And first of all, let's take a picture in auto mode. There will be A in every camera. Get close to this. Here you could find a it means auto mode. Everything camera will going to do itself automatically. It will control
green
ISO.
Green A.
This one. So whenever if you feel I am not enough, I don't have knowledge to how to operate all this thing, put it in auto mode and take the picture or video. And I will tell you how to take the picture in manual mode. There is another manual mode. Okay, don't press it. It identify that your lighting condition is low. Therefore, it automatically get open. And manually you have to manage this thing. When it is auto mode, automatically it senses. If you press it, it open the light. And as per your need of the frame, then you have to take the picture. Oh, first of all, let's take a open that cover. Camera lens hood. इसको lens hood बोलते हैं. इसको cover निकालना है. Okay, so let's start. Take some photographs with help of auto mode. You could take photographs of this flower. And try to increase the stability. You could take the help of the ground. You could touch your knee so that it will add stability. Okay. Then, and your shoulder, you could put it like this. ठीक है ना? ताकि आपका arms support करेगा. जितने ज़्यादा आप support होगा, आप हिलेगा नहीं. ठीक है ना? Sensor is also sensitive towards the movement of your hand, otherwise it will not take the right picture. So let's take some pictures. Frame the so everyone take one picture at least. Anna, you take another picture in auto mode. Let me explain you some basic how to handle this camera. First of all, you have to hold it properly. In neck mein gale mein dalna hai aapko. You have to hold like this. And the second hand should be like this. You have to so that you could get more support. And ye haath aapka yahan support lena chahiye. Theek hai?
देन यू हैव टू होल्ड दिस लाइट. तो ये कहीं भी मूव नहीं करेगा, सपोर्ट रहेगा, रेस्ट होगा. दिस एक्ट एज अ ट्राइपॉड फॉर सपोर्ट. इट विल बी बेटर इफ यू टेक द हेल्प ऑफ यू हैव एनी सपोर्ट लाइक दिस. टेक सपोर्ट लाइक दिस. आप कर सकते हो, ये अपना फ्रेम यहाँ लगा सकते हो. सो नाउ इफ यू टेक एनी काइंड ऑफ फोटोग्राफ. Let me tell you something about this camera. So this is how to switch it on. You could find here there is on and off button. Now it's off. First of all, you have to remove the viewfinder, the cover of this lens. Then switch it on. Okay, it will take some time. You could see, there is a on and off button. This is on, then on. Okay, then here you could see there is start and stop button. This is only dedicated for photography and videography. There is a two option we have, photograph and videograph. You could move like this. Okay, now you could see the display, video display. Okay, and is it visible? Okay, so now you could move to, now we are talking about photography. If you want to see in a display, now you could see in, this is viewfinder. इसमें हम देख सकते हैं क्या हम capture करने वाले, what we are going to capture. You just press it like this, you could see in our digital display. Okay, here you could find so many manuals are there. If we move this thing to manual mode, you have to press like this, this one. Press it and move it to manual mode. In the manual mode, you could find so many options are there. Okay, here you could find ISO. This is f-stop. This is shutter speed. Three things we have to manage while we take any photographs. Okay, this is again ISO. This is shutter speed. This is 4.5, and this one is
ISO.
No, this one is ISO. Shutter this one speed. Is shutter speed 50. Mm-hmm. It means 50 frame photograph it could take in within frames 1 second. Mm-hmm. Okay.
So please repeat this portion.
Okay.
Videography.
Yes, we have two options. We could take photograph for this. White mark should be toward the camera signal. Okay. Here we could change to video mode. Photography and video mode. Okay. And here also in video mode, you could see the audio level also displaying. Right? So, if you move to... If you do not know anything about how to take pictures, so what you could do? Move to manual, press it, and it should be A. In different company, they have different symbols, but in Canon, it is A. Green A sign is there. Okay. So in manual mode, you just have to frame, and this screen could be flipped. Okay. So if you want to take any low angle photograph, suppose I want to take. Okay. Here, you could see. दिखाई दे रहा है इसमें?
Yes.
When there is a situation, there is a light part, brighter part and dark part, it's difficult to capture the visuals properly. So try to frame it either in bright or light. Okay, this is a touch sensitive camera. If you want to focus over any part of this picture, you could touch it and it will get automatically get focused. One thing you have to remember, there is two another options, A and MF. MF means manual focus, AF means autofocus. Okay, if you want to take everything in auto mode, you have to put it in like this. Otherwise, it will not get focused. Another thing, there is a stabilizer. Stabilizer is when we take any visuals, video, it should be in on mode. Otherwise, it absorbs your sick. Okay, जो आप हाथ हिलाओगे कुछ करोगे उसको दिखाई देगा विजुअल में. ओके, ऑटो में करने के लिए यू हैव टू ऑन, एवरीथिंग शुड बी ऑन, देन ओनली कुड टेक ऑटो मोड. सो लेट्स टेक वन पिक्चर्स इन ऑटो मोड. ओके, आई हैव जस्ट फ्रेम्ड, देन यू हैव टू हैव प्रेस फॉर टू टेक एनी फोटो सो दैट कैमरा कुड गेट ऑटोमेटिकली दे एडजस्ट देमसेल्फ दैट यू आर गोइंग टू टेक एनी पिक्चर्स. They get the instruction, then full press. Okay, I am in a video mode, therefore I am unable to take photographs. For before taking any photograph, it should be in a photo mode. Okay, again, let me frame it and half press, then full press. Now we have photographs, and to see how you have take to preview the photographs, we could play. We could press the play button. Okay, now it is. We could zoom it. We could see whether it is perfect or not. Okay, so I think everyone know how to take photograph in a auto mode. So it's so easy. You have to move it F mode, stabilization on mode, and it should be on. It should be at auto mode, and it should be photograph mode, and frame the camera and take the clip pictures. First of all, you have to press half press, then full press. Okay. And let's talk about manual mode. Manual means we could control everything. We could control the light, intensity of light, how much light should enter inside the camera. So we have three different options. One is shutter speed, one other is ISO, another is what? Aperture. And technically we call it f-stop. If f number is increased, it means aperture size is small. Okay, here you could see the camera aperture could be decrease and increase. Here you could see the lens, there is aperture. Okay, so first of all, let's see what you could do if we there is another some manual modes are there. P mode, TV mode, AV mode, B mode, there are some others options are there. Okay, so let's move first of all to manual. Here we could control everything. Okay. Here you could see. Now nothing, we could not see anything. दिखाई दे रहा है आपको? इसमें कुछ भी नहीं दिखाई दे रहा. It's completely white. It means more amount of light we are getting inside the camera. So what we could do, first of all you could change its ISO. It now ISO is how much?
4000.
So try to decrease as much as possible to get your lighting. So if your ISO is more, there is some side effect also there. You will get grain image. You will get grain in the image. Some destruction you could find if ISO is increased. So try to make ISO as low as possible.
It's the same as when you crop a picture too much.
Right,
the quality is not good then. So it's the same as ISO
ISO, extra noise will you could find something. Let me check you. Let me show you how we could get this. Suppose I will take a photographs. Let increase the ISO. But in the lighting, if any in a natural lighting condition, if I increase the ISO, another demerit is that I can't capture the light. But in the dark situation, we could increase its ISO. Now I can't take the photographs because this ISO is too high, so that it captures more light. I can't take any photographs. Simply white photo I will get. Okay, you could see nothing in the frame. So definitely I need to. So it's ideal to. ISO, keep ISO under 800 or under 400. Okay, ideal situation है. आप जितने कम कर सको कर सकते हो. ठीक है, हम यहाँ पर हम देखते हैं कब 100 में जब जाते हैं तभी भी हमें ISO क्या होता है, लाइट ज़्यादा पाते हैं. Now here you could see at 100 ISO we are getting more lights. So what else we could do? We could decrease its aperture. If there is more light coming inside the camera, we could decrease. So how we could decrease? Here we could decrease the f-stop. You could increase the f-stop. Okay, this is the f-stop. Here you could see this is f-stop. When we increase the f-stop, it means aperture is decreasing, so less light is coming inside the camera. You could see when we decrease the f-stop, it means more lights are coming. It means aperture, size of aperture is larger. ठीक है, ओके. तो ISO भी हम क्या कर सकते हैं, जब बढ़ाते हैं ISO sensitivity बढ़ता है कैमरा का, and we get more light. Okay, then another thing is shutter speed, means in 1 second how much
frames
you could take. So you could click here, and here you could see. So if we take less number of frame in a second, it means more light enter inside our camera. Getting my point? It means we are giving more time to get exposed our sensor. Okay. If frame rate is less, it means we are giving more time to our sensor get exposed. ठीक है, आप अगर इसमें देखोगे इसके अंदर एक शटर है, शटर मतलब जब क्लिक करोगे आपको एक आवाज़ आएगा. लेट मी यू कुड हियर दिस, यू कुड सी, इट मीन्स देर इज ए शटर, इट गेट ओपन फॉर ए फ्रैक्शन ऑफ सेकेंड एंड अलाउ लाइट टू एंटर इनसाइड द कैमरा. सो हियर यू कुड चेंज. ओके, सपोज आई मेक इट 30 सेकेंड, नो I make it 1, it means it take 1 second to capture the photographs. Let me, you could identify the amount of time it take. Let me, it take 1 second to capture the photograph. So our photograph get exposed. So definitely for this scenario, we have to increase its shutter speed so that if it is 250, means it takes fraction of 250 fraction of a second to take picture. So let's try this. We could not identify maybe. So quickly it take pictures. Okay. So another problem here. Our location is quite huge amount of light is there. So we have to decrease the ISO. Already you have to decrease to, let me decrease first of all ISO. So first what you have to do, we have to decrease the ISO as less as possible. Suppose I decrease its ISO to 200. Okay, so it's a dark enough, then I could take shutter speed around 60, then f-stop I could increase little bit. Okay, now it's okay. I could take the photographs. So in the next class we are going to do more practical how to use all these three things, but fundamentally today we learn the three different factors we should remember while taking any photographs, that is ISO and shutter speed and aperture. So before end this class, take some photographs by changing shutter speed, ISO and aperture. One by one, take one photograph at least. So main objective is to, our photograph should not be dark, it should not be bright. If it is more bright, you can't see anything. If it is completely dark, you could not see anything. Okay, if you have any doubt? Okay, so let's take some photographs. You could take your own personal photographs also. Okay, start. Okay.